Hello student, welcome back in the animal tissues. Today is the turn of muscular tissue. Already we have finished epithelial tissues and connective tissues. So today you will be learned about the muscular tissue or the muscles. Muscular tissues are a type of tissues which brings two things, that is called the locomotion and movement. So muscular tissue is responsible for bringing locomotion and movement to the body and its body parts. So this muscular tissue is, why it is giving the power to locomotion or the movement to the body parts? Because they are made up of the specialized tissues, or they are made up of specialized cells. That cells are called as myoblast. What is a myoblast? Myoblast is a type of specialized cells which forming the muscle cells. And in turn, the muscle cells is made up of muscle fiber. These muscle fibers are very minute, highly elastic power. They have a very good flexibility. So this is called the muscle fiber. If we compare total that things about the muscular tissue is that, so muscular tissue is a specialized tissue that is made up of myoblast and muscle fibers. What are the properties of a muscle fibers? Muscle fibers providing the flexibility to the muscles. Therefore, this muscular tissue giving the locomotion and movement to the body and its body part. Now, if you see the single muscles or the myoblast, what you find there, this is the centralized portion that is called the nucleus. Okay, here these are the strings like structure or fiber like structure that is calling the myofibrin or myofibers. And this outermost boundary layer is called sarcolemma. That is, the plasma membrane is here known as sarcolemma. Next, the fluid contains, that cytoplasmic contains in the muscles is known as sarcoplasm. This is a general views about the muscles or muscular tissues or about the myoblast. So, on the basis of their structure and function, muscular tissues in the animals are three types. Number one is striated muscles, number two is unstriated muscles, and number three is cardiac muscles. Now, what is the striated muscle? As the name is suggesting, striated, it means it has striation, that is the bands. So the muscles which having light band and dark band in parallel to that is known as the striated muscle. Actually, since these muscles are joined or they are bound to the our skeletal system or about the bone, so we call it the striated muscle or skeletal muscle. Even when the muscle is joined with our bones or skeletal system, so we can easily rotate our hand, we can easily bowl, we can easily move. So this movement is mainly due to the striated muscles, and therefore we call it is a voluntary muscles. It means these are the muscles which you can move on your will. It means the movement in this type muscle is under your control. So this is about the striated muscle. Example of striated muscle is your hand, your leg, your wrist, this neck region, wherever you can easily move, that is the example of striated muscle. Now, these striated muscle get fatigue very soon. Out of these three muscles, this is the muscles which require high demand of ATP energy, and due to lack of the ATP energy, what happened? Muscles get fatigue. That is, it is a tired muscle. And now the number two is the unstriated muscle. These unstriated muscles do not have any bands, light or dark bands, like the previous one, striated muscle. This striated muscle is having more than one nucleus, so it is known as multinucleated. But on the other hand, unstriated muscle is having only one nucleus, so we call it the uninucleate. And The shape is spindle shape, that is, this is the pointed end and that another one is also the pointed end. So unstriated muscle is spindle shape and their both end are tapering, that is, they have the pointed end. And there is a center, you can see here, nucleus. So nucleus is single here and it is uninucleate. And these bands are known as myofibril. This is called the myofibril or muscle fiber. And this part is called as the sarcoplasm, that the fluid portion is known as the sarcoplasm. It is equal to cytoplasm of the cell. Now these muscles rarely fatigue as compared to the striated muscle. Striated muscle very soon fatigue, but it rarely fatigue. Now this is also known as visceral muscles or involuntary muscle. Why do we call visceral muscles? Because these muscles are present in our visceral organs, so we call it the visceral muscles. And why it is involuntary muscle? Because this muscle is not under our willpower or under not in our, it is not under our control, so it is called involuntary muscles. So this is about the unstriated muscle. Now the location of the unstriated muscle in our body system. So mostly it is present in the alimentary canal. It is also present in your respiratory system. While we eating food, what happened? There is a peristalsis movement takes place in the esophageal region. What happened? That is contract relax. This continuous process is going on when the food is passing towards the stomach. So it is also present blinking of our eyes. You cannot control the blinking of your eyes because it is under the iris, is there in the eyes. So iris is made up of the these involuntary muscles by which we can open or close our eyes. Next, it is also present in our urinogenital system, respiratory system, and even the covering of the blood vessels. So this is example of the unstriated muscles or involuntary muscles. These both muscles, unstriated muscle and unstriated muscle, that is voluntary muscle as well as involuntary muscle, both are unbranched. There is no branching. Next, third one is the cardiac muscle. As the name suggests, cardiac, it is related with the heart. So our heart is made up what kind of muscle? That is the cardiac muscle. This cardiac muscle is the intermix of the striated as well as unstriated muscle. Why? It has some light and dark band, so it is striated and branched. Therefore, there is single nucleus. It has uninucleated, but striated is multinucleated. So this muscle is never fatigue in lifetime. After the birth, when once the cardiac muscle is started, it never lost or it never stopped. After the death, it is stopped. So this cardiac muscle is known as tireless muscle or fatigueless muscle. It never undergo the fatigue. Therefore, it is called never get fatigue muscles. And these cardiac muscles, just I told, it has a branching and they have the bands. So it is a single muscle which is branched and intermediate of the both striated muscle as well as unstriated muscles. So this is about the muscular tissues in the animal tissues or whatever the muscle tissue or muscular tissues found in the animals. Thanks for watching.